A good sign. The judges here tonight, well, an all-star lineup. Julius Erving, Maurice Lucas, George Gervin, Paul Silas, Calvin Murphy. Calvin down on the right side there. You see Mo Lucas on the left. And Paul Silas there, the second from the right. Craig Sager in our picture will be talking to some of the competitors. And our first competitor tonight will be Robert Pack, out of Southern Cal, playing for Denver Nuggets now at 6'2". The players drew for the order of dunking tonight, and it'll be Robert Pack, James Robinson, Allen Houston, Isaiah Ryder, Antonio Davis, and Sean Kemp in that order. So, first of all, just remember that there is a 90-second routine that'll be happening here. There was a minimum of three dunks. Once the music starts, the player has 90 seconds. Then he'll be judged on that total package and get one score from our panel of judges. A change in the slam dunk competition. The clock hasn't started yet. It is now starting. Robert Pack, who played in the same backcourt with Harold Miner. Now remember, it doesn't matter if he misses because he'll be judged on his whole performance. Entire 90 seconds, a minute left for Robert Pack. Oh, 6'2", throwing that down with power. Seconds left for Robert Pack. Each competitor needs to attempt at least three dunks. Oh, that's a beauty off the bounce and the reverse. A lot of tens being shown up in the stands for Robert Pack, and that is his routine. The players don't have to use all 90 seconds. He made four dunks and missed one, and he'll get one score for his routine from our panel of judges. All right, Charles, how about these replays? Give us a view of your opinion here.
Bob, you know what's amazing about, do you give a guy, this is a small guy who do amazing dunks, and is he going to get his justice? Because I think it's more difficult to do the dunks Robert has done because of his height. Obviously, a big guy can do these dunks a lot easier. So I think it's up to the judge's discretion whether you give a guy credit for being small doing nice dunks or a bigger guy.
Well, there's the score, Charles. You see it on the screen for the first round. That's a score for his performance of 42 with a maximum out of 50.
I think those scores are kind of low. Those are hard dunks because of his size.
I agree with you, Charles. I tell you, he had power and he had creativity and he had a nice style to it all.
Our next competitor, James Robinson, already starting his routine. James Robinson out of the University of Alabama, also a guard, also a young, small fella at 6'2".
You can see he has explosion, Bob.
Yeah, he's kind of an underdog favorite here for some of the crowds of people who have seen this youngster play in college. Well, yo, are y'all ready for me yet? Well, yo, are y'all ready for me yet? 47 seconds, a minimum of three dunks per competitor. They can throw it down as many times as they want in their 90-second routine. Routine of James Robinson. He made four dunks. He missed one, so he'll be judged on those four by our panel of judges, Mo Lucas, Gervin, Silas, Murphy, and Erving. I love this game. Charles? Give us your thoughts here.
Well, I tell you what, James Robinson wasn't good as Robert Pack. And he had a couple of really nice dunks, but I don't think he was as good as Robert Pack. What do you think, Dominique?
Well, I think, you know, his effort was good, but Robert Pack had a lot more force on his dunks, and one of the dunks that Robinson did, it didn't quite make it, you know, over the rim. He kind of skipped.
A rub in?
Yeah, kind of a tweener, you know what I mean?
A rub in tweener. Yeah, you hear it from the men themselves. Robinson, you fellas were right, Charles. You see, he got a 39. And next up now, this is the man who is replacing Harold Miner, whose back did not allow him to participate. Allen Houston, who played at the University of Tennessee, now with the Detroit Pistons, known more for his outside game. But remember, Allen Houston was a high jumper in high school, did win a slam dunk competition when he was in high school, and let's see what his 90-second routine is. And by the way, Doug Collins, the winning coach of the rookie game, has joined us here. Congratulations, Coach.
Hey, nice to see you guys. Okay.
We thought last year that the judges were tough on people because they want the energy, the originality, and the creativity. They want to see it all. Then they hang you up with that thing called power. They want the power.
You saw Patrick Ewing, Dikembe Mutombo on the sideline. All the All-Stars turn out for the slam dunk competition. Scottie Pippen. Behind his back off the glass. Off his head. I see chuckles from the judges. I don't know if that, and of course from the All-Stars who are on the sideline. Charles Barkley, give us your thoughts on Allen Houston.
Well, I don't know if he's gonna win, but that was the most original dunk I've ever seen that bounced off the head. That was great.
Off the backboard, first of all, for the jam. But the one that really got the judges excited was the dunk off the head. And it puts him in second place right now. The judges are giving Allen Houston a 41-5. So Robert Pack with a 42, James Robinson with a 39, and a 41-5 for Allen Houston. And remember, out of these six competitors, three will advance to the finals. There you go in the first round. The scores, you see what Ryder, Davis, and Kemp have to beat. And up next, this is the man on draft day who guaranteed a win. And Doug, you said you were going to play until he dropped. How are his legs?
I think he's okay. I think he's all right. I talked to him. And he and Antonio Davis, I think they're going to be okay. Now, he's got an opportunity here because he's got the crowd already behind him. And if he gets them excited with the first couple dunks, he should be in good shape.
And Charles, both David and David Robinson and Dominique have selected this one to win.
I think he's got a good point, but I think the judges are going to be influenced by the crowd.
Hey, Charles, this is Doug. Looked like Allen Houston bounced that ball off your head when he dunked it that time.
It would have bounced higher on my head.
Isaiah Ryder. Well, that brought the crowd to their feet. Now, they are prejudiced, but the All-Stars on the sideline are not necessarily, and they, too, came to their feet. 90 seconds, he has to have three dunks. Look at the look on the faces of the players, see Kevin Johnson.
You know what, he's got to be careful about expending an awful lot of energy here and getting nothing done. You know, he's got one dunk down.
The two that are down, counting this one now, however, have been the most spectacular of the night so far.
Now, I guess he's going to save that corner dunk where he takes the ball between his legs for the finals. I guess he figures he's in the finals, QB, so.
He just waved it off, Doug. I think he was going to attempt it. Now he just changed his mind.
All right, that'll count as three. But he better get in another big one if he wants to move into the finals here. 9 seconds left.
When they say power, they also want it to be clean.
That was big.
Well, I like that because everything else he did was bouncing the ball off the floor. This is something a little different, Hubie.
Well, last year, anybody who bounced, they would get blown.
Yeah.
Charles Barkley, what do you and your compadres think about that?
What do you think, David Robinson?
He played the crowd for all it was worth, boy, but he's got some ups.
Dominique?
He reminded me of myself when I was younger. He looked good.
Dominique said it best. He reminded him of himself when he was younger.
Not quite yet, Dominique.
No, I don't think so.
Ryder with the highest score so far, a 46.8 for the. And remember, they're being judged on the entire 90-second performance. That does put Isaiah Ryder in the finals as they stand right now. So there you see. Right now, it's Ryder, Pack, and Houston. Davis and Kemp have to beat 41-5 and 42 to move into the final three. And our next dunker from Indiana, Antonio Davis, who is replacing the injured Doug Christie of the Los Angeles Lakers.
Bob, I want to tell you something. I've never really seen this young guy play in person. This guy's a good basketball player. When I put him in the game tonight, the whole game changed, Hubie. He can rebound. This kid is a good basketball player.
He has 90 seconds now for his dunk opportunity. Between the legs and down. Now, this is a big dunker. Antonio Davis at 6'9". Sometimes this reflects in the judge's opinion of how good his dunk is. 360. See some of the All-Stars on the sideline holding up their scores. Antonio Davis played 20 minutes in the rookie game also.
So well, I had to have him out there, Bob. He was good. I'm telling you, I really like his game. He's got power. He's got good hands. You know, it's tough sometimes, Hubie, for the big guys to do some of the creative things the guards can do because they can't handle the ball as well.
Oh, windmill two-handed jam by Antonio Davis.
Now, this guy is powerful. He's making it look too easy.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's the routine for Antonio Davis. He only used up less than a minute of his 90 seconds allotted time. Let's see what the judges think of that. Charles Barkley, how about your opinion?
He did some nice dunks, but I think because of his size, they're not going to give him really, really high scores. I think he's going to get penalized because of his height. Those dunks aren't easy, but the judges will consider them easy because of his height.
You know, Charles, don't you think it's hard sometimes for the big guys to do some creative things off the dribble that the smaller players can do?
I think it's, the judges do penalize the big guys if they don't do something really, really fancy.
As you see, Charles, on our screen there, Davis and Robinson have been eliminated. The three who are now advancing to the finals, as of now, are Ryder, Pack, and Houston. But Sean Kemp is next up, and he is the favorite in the eyes of some of the folks.
He's been my favorite for 4 years. It's about time for him to come through here tonight.
Kemp needs at least a 41-5 from the judges. This is on his first attempt. I'll remind you once again, 90 seconds for the players. They must attempt at least three dunks.
Now that was power, Hubie. There's your power dunk.
He brought that from the mezzanine.
Big one from Sean Kemp at 6'10". Dikembe Mutombe, you see Charles Oakley, Danny Manning on the sideline, Patrick Ewing, the All-Stars in the background with Charles Barkley, Dominique Wilkins, David Robinson, they're all out here tonight. Behind the back jam!
See, there's a little charisma. A little charisma there.
Sean Kemp walking off to a standing O. Charles Barkley, tell us about it.
Well, I can't get a word in because Gary Payton is the biggest cheerleader in the world over here. Sean Kemp is definitely going to be in the finals. And it's going to come down, I think, to him and Isaiah Ryder. There's going to be a two-team, two-man race. Those guys are definitely the two best. But Robert Pack coming in a close third.
Sean Kemp with power throwing it down. So let's see who has advanced here. The three in white have advanced. It is Ryder, Kemp, and Pack who will advance to the finals. Two dunks each. They'll be graded on their best, and we'll be right back with the final round.
The
through the slam dunk competition here tonight. Our three finalists are Isaiah Ryder, Sean Kemp, and Robert Pack. And they will go in reverse order of their total points. That means Robert Pack will go first. The rules are simple. Each player has two dunks, no replacement dunks, and only the best dunk will count. And, of course, the maximum score will be 50. Nobody got a 50 on the 90-second reviews of our panel of judges in the first round of six. So we'll be down to three now. Each will have two dunks, and we will move our competition to the basket on our right. It'll be Pack going first, Sean Kemp second, and then Isaiah Ryder. Here's Robert Pack, 6'2". Out of Southern Cal, plays for the Denver Nuggets. Explosive young man.
Robert Pack, over here.
Yo.
Now, no clock on this, simply two dunks. And I will mention one other thing that's sometimes vague in the minds of our viewer. A dunk that doesn't count is one that the player never lets out of his hand, no matter what he does. If he holds on to it, it won't count. If he tries to dunk it and he misses, then it's just missed. That's Pack's first one. That's a beauty.
Give it up for our best.
Only 6'2".
Next up
will be Sean Kemp. Let's have a look at the Charles Barkley. What do you think about the Robert Pack dunk attempt?
I tell you, Robert Pack is, unfortunately, I don't think he can win, but I think he might have been the best dunker here. But because the crowd is so excited by Sean Kemp and J.R. Ryder, this guy is a small guy. He's not 6 feet tall, and the dunk he's doing is pretty amazing.
And the judges have given him on that first dunk a 43.8. And now each player will dunk once, rotating through the three finalists, and then they'll have another opportunity. So our second player with his first dunk attempt in the final round is Sean Kemp. Charles, give us the play-by-play on this one.
Well, he's getting all limber. I think he's going to do something good.
Now, he will not get to replace that, so Sean Kemp has missed his dunk. He will get to. I will remind fans that only one score will count, not a cumulative score. Lost the handle on it. Charles, could you see that?
You know, I think Sean Kemp is like me. I cannot palm a ball, and he can't either. And I think it just slipped out of his hand. Anytime I try to dunk, I try to use two hands or cup the ball. And I think the same thing happened to Sean on that situation. The ball just slipped out of his hand.
So on the missed dunk, Sean Kemp got a 25. But now remember, it's only one score that counts, so you'll just throw that out. And the number to beat right now is 43.8. And here's the local hometown favorite, Isaiah Ryder.
If he does that corner dunk where he takes the ball between his legs and comes up around the basket, that's his signature dunk that he made famous last year in the NCAA dunk contest.
As he's moving the shot clock, the cameraman, and the Gatorade containers, Isaiah's also an interior designer here at the Target Center. Here we go, Isaiah Ryder.
Get that one he wraps under his leg.
Isaiah is 6'5". He's not happy with the setup over there, right in front of Scottie Pippen. Let's see if he asks Scottie Pippen to move. I doubt that.
Scottie Pippen got three NBA championship rings. He can't ask him to move.
Good point, Charles. Oh, between his legs. How about it, Charles Barkley? What do you think?
Oh, my God. That might be the best dunk I ever seen. That was awesome. We got a winner.
Let's see what the judges give him. Remember, the high score is the one that'll win out of all the dunks here. A 49 from the judges.
Hey, guys.
Yes, Charles.
Wait for the
Charles, how about your instant replay of yourself?
Hey, you know what? I want to know what happened to his other point.
He should have got a 50.
Somebody of the five judges gave him a 9.
Charles, they wanted to keep the competition open here. That's what happened.
It has to be Dr. J, because he's the only one over there who can expect something better than that.
What, Charles, what did Dominique have to say about
Dominique,
that?
Dominique, what did you listen to this?
Well, you know, I think it was a 50, no question about it. You got Dr. J, who's a veteran dunker, and the other two are jump shooters. They are, I think it was a mistake.
So there you go. Charles, remember Dominique and Michael Jordan in Chicago a few years ago. So Dominique will probably remember that competition with Michael in Chicago.
Well, you know what?
That was a home court job then.
Here's Robert Pack, who missed his dunk. So he has only the 43.8 to go with. That means Ryder has already eliminated Pack. And Sean Kemp's dunk here has to beat 49, or Isaiah Ryder will win the Gatorade Slam Dunk Championship. So it's all down to Sean Kemp's final dunk.
Well, J.R. Ryder said last year during the draft that he was going to win the dunk contest. So the pressure's on Sean Kemp now to make him dunk one more time.
Charles, did you hear what Sean Kemp said to Craig Sager earlier? He didn't want to be the Buffalo Bills of the dunk competition.
Well, he is going to be. I'm a Buffalo Bill fan, but he can forget this one. That dunk by Isaiah Ryder is... I don't know if I've ever seen a dunk like that before. That was awesome.
Sean is going coast to coast, Charles.
I think the judges have seen this dunk a lot, and I don't think they'll give him a 50 on it.
Okay, I like the fact that you do speak your mind. Sean Kemp. The title is eluded him 4 times. Lost the handle on the ball, and I think you had it right, Charles. He could not get a good grip on the basketball.
He's got real small hands. I can't palm a ball. I don't think Sean Kemp can either, and that cost him.
So Kemp only got 25 on his first missed dunk. He'll get a score here, but it's certainly not going to beat Isaiah Ryder, who got the 49. Now, Isaiah Ryder will not have to dunk again, but I think he has agreed to do another dunk. Let's see.
You know what? I think that's pretty. I think that's pretty amazing that even though he has a competition, if he does another dunk, that shows a lot of class on his part.
Charles, let's see if he does the one now where he pulls his shirt over his head and he dunks it. Those are the two he won the NCAA dunk competition, the one between his legs. And he does one where he pulls his shirt up over his head and dunks it.
So Isaiah Ryder is going to just do one more dunk to thrill the crowd. Charles, give us the play-by-play.
Well, I don't think he can do anything better than to pass that first dunk. We should have handed him a trophy after that dunk.
Talking to his men on the side there, asking for some thoughts on the dunk, and here comes Isaiah Ryder. Well, as the Cowboys coach Jimmy Johnson said, if you talk the talk, you got to walk the walk. Isaiah Ryder guaranteed this win.
He walking and talking.
Well, that left no doubt in the minds of anybody here at the Target Center. The hometown favorite, Minnesota Timberwolves, who haven't, Charles, had much to cheer about this year, have something to cheer about now.
Well, I tell you what, he put on a great performance. And I guess now next year the game's in Phoenix, we got to get somebody who's a good dunker so we can steal it at home, too.
They gave Isaiah Ryder a 47 on that one, but it was his first dunk. This one that won the competition with a score of 49. Back with the AT&T long distance shootout after the trophy presentation, right after this.